This module is sponsored by the Children's Services Council of Broward County. The KidVision VPK group went to explore the Anne Kolb Nature Center in Broward County, Florida. There we met Justin, a naturalist. Where are we going on this boat?
We are going to explore our native ecosystem and take a look at all of our mangroves and our estuaries, and we might be able to see some fish and some crabs and some other really cool things.
Can I ask you a question? What kind of boat is this?
So this is a pontoon boat.
A pontoon boat is a boat with a flat bottom and floats on both sides.
So we're going to go on the boat, but first we have to do a couple things. We have to take some life jackets and then place them around our necks, because that is what? What was that going to do for us?
Help us safe.
Keep us safe, that's right?
And help us float.
Yeah, that's right. We have mangroves all around us. One of my favorite mangroves is actually the red mangrove. The red mangroves, you'll be able to tell because they have these pointy leaves. The purpose of the mangroves, it actually provides a very good habitat to a lot of different species. They are homes to a lot of different birds, and they are homes to a lot of different fish. A lot of ocean fish actually come here because this water that you see around here, do you see that kind of film on the top of the water? It kind of looks very murky, cloudy. That is actually nutrient. That's plankton that's coming in to our mangrove system.
Do fish eat plankton?
Yes, a lot of small fish will feed on plankton. A lot of different crabs and other organisms feed on the plankton too. And have you ever heard of the word brackish water before? So brackish water is a mix of fresh water. Where does the fresh water come from?
The river.
The river, the lake, and then how about the rain that falls down? Where does the salty, salty water come from?
The ocean.
Fresh water and salt water make brackish water, and that's what these mangroves live in. They live in brackish water because it's where the sea meets the land.
This is known as a mangrove tree crab.
Oh.
You sure can. So this mangrove tree crab will live on the mangrove leaves, and it will actually eat the red mangrove. It loves the leaves of the red mangrove. All right, guys, come on in. Let's go explore the eco room and our touch tank.
Here, come stand over here so you can get a good look. We have to set up the environment so that they live well and they are healthy. So you see they're in water and they have sand. This is their environment.
So let me see if I can grab a sea urchin for you to take a look at. So it is known as a pencil sea urchin. Why do you think they call it a pencil sea urchin?
Because it has pencils.
Those little blacky look like pencils.
So they have these little spines, and you know what natives used to do here to Florida, in Florida? They would take these spines and then they would actually write on rocks and they would communicate with each other.
Wow.
Yeah. So we also have, this is known as a chocolate chip sea star. They have these little bumps, and from a distance it almost looks like chocolate chips on top of them.
Oh, I see.
So I wouldn't recommend to eat these. They definitely don't taste like chocolate chips.
No. So these are
tentacles.
Wow, that's right. What color are they?
Purple.
Purple. Mm-hmm. And what would they use tentacles for?
To stick on stuff like this.
Right, so they can crawl around. What is that?
Horseshoe crab.
Let's check it out.
Yeah, let's take a look. I'm gonna pick him up out of the water.
And I saw a booby.
Oh my gosh.
He does move. So this tail, do you think this is toxic in any way? Would this hurt us? Venomous?
He's trying.
Yes.
No, this is actually not. So this is just used to right itself up when a wave pushes it over. So when he flips over, he'll use that tail to spring back up and be on the normal side again. Now, we're going to go on our nature trail and see things right by our eyes and our faces. I have brought some really cool tools, and we are actually going to take a couple samples and use them, right? And everybody will get a chance to use them. Do you guys want to use some of my cool tools?
Yeah!
Why do you use tools to collect samples?
So we use tools because they help us make observations. Does everybody know what an observation means?
What? Yeah! A project that we want to do.
Yeah, similar to a project that we might want to do. And we are going to take a close look and explore. That's right. So this is called a seine. Can everybody say seine?
Seine.
So a seine allows water to go through the bottom, but it collects all of the mud or other sample that you want to keep. But this is called a mud grab. A mud grab. So that's what we're gonna do. Do you guys wanna try it? Do you wanna collect samples with me?
Sure!
Awesome, all right. I'm gonna hand this to you. And then we're gonna lower it down. We're gonna lower it down, right? Okay. A little bit more. We're gonna hold it out just like this. Keep holding, can you hold on tight? And then when I count to three, we're gonna drop it, okay? One, two, three. Is everybody ready?
Yeah, we're all ready.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's take a look. Oh!
Let's use our senses to explore this wonderful mud. We can look, touch, and smell.
Let's take another sample.
Okay. We are taking a water sample to collect plankton. Water is heavy.
We have collected some plankton in our plankton net, and now we get to take a look at them under the microscope.
A microscope is a tool that magnifies. It makes very little things we can't see with our eyes bigger so that we can see them. Scientific tools like microscopes, watch glasses, eyedroppers, and petri dishes help the KidVision Pre-K Kids look closely at plankton and mud samples. We see that plankton is made up of very tiny animals and plants. Plankton is good food for bigger fish and crabs.
You're so welcome, Miss Penny. Thanks for stopping by. I had a lot of fun with everybody too, and I hope you guys come back and see our nature center again.
We will.
Bye. They like it. Come on, we'll come back another day. Say bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye.